the land grant mission has had a tremendous and profound impact on the food safety and security around the world.
Well, we definitely need the land grant system so that we have researchers that can help agriculture to produce more and safer products.
As a product of land grant universities myself, I can say that the influence of these universities have far reaches beyond the shores of the U.S.
In the past 150 years, America's land-grant universities have revolutionized modern agriculture and made farms more productive and more environmentally sustainable. The research and training programs developed by the 76 institutions that make up the land-grant system have not only allowed the world to feed its growing population, but have given the population a better quality of life. This year, as we celebrate the 150th anniversary of the Morrill Act, the legislation that created the land-grant system, the World Food Prize Foundation decided to award this group of universities with the Borlaug Medallion, the highest honor available to groups who work to increase international food production and nutrition. The Borlaug Medallion recognizes the contributions made by land-grant researchers to the development of more productive crop varieties, more sustainable farming practices, and safer, better food preservation techniques. The award also recognizes the land-grant university's unflinching commitment to the idea that knowledge is the key to improving health and well-being around the globe.
The impact of researchers at land-grant institutions on food safety and security around the world is tremendous, is significant, and it should be. The land-grant mission has been and continues to be improving the lives of citizens of the United States predominantly, but also around the world.
Well, I direct a Center for Food Safety at the University of Georgia and also do research here. And the research we do is largely designed to develop better ways to detect and control the harmful microbes that you sometimes find in food. We do a lot of work all the way from the farm to the consumer and have developed treatments that span the entire food chain. We've been very successful in developing many of the practical ways that farmers as well as processors can use to treat foods to make them safer.
The research projects that I'm most proud of are my carbon footprint work. The carbon footprint project helps the farmer to use his resources responsibly and economically, and it also helps him to maintain his manure. If a grower uses manure that's contaminated with pathogens to grow vegetable crops, that can in effect affect the food supply chain, which leads to economic losses, and it can also lead to food safety issues where we end up having foodborne illnesses.
The research to date that we've done that I'm most proud about because of its impact has been work to develop molecular or DNA-based assays to detect plant pathogens in seeds. If seeds are shipped around the world, they not only can introduce these pathogens into areas where they have not existed before, so you introduce these invasive species, but it can also severely affect seed quality. And so if we have poor quality seeds, we're most assuredly going to have a poor crop. So if we can do anything to increase the quality of the seeds that we produce and we distribute around the world, we'll give individuals a good chance of producing a healthy crop, especially if those seeds don't have pathogens associated with them.
As American land-grant universities developed ways to feed our growing world, they became a cornerstone of the American educational system, offering an unprecedented number of people a chance at post-secondary education and a better life. The University of Georgia opened the door to higher education for hundreds of thousands of Georgians, fundamentally changing the way the state lives, works, and raises its families. Land-grant universities not only made a post-secondary degree accessible to the general public, but also created the expectation that students must obtain some kind of training after high school in order to be successful.
The mission of a land-grant university was to educate youngsters in agriculture and mechanics.
And as a result, it somehow flattened the playing field and gave individuals who otherwise would not have a way to change their socioeconomic status an opportunity to gain this education and change not only their lives, but the lives of their descendants.
As we celebrate the accomplishments of the researchers, teachers, and extension agents who have contributed to the success of the first 150 years of the land grant system, we are already looking to the future, knowing there will always be people in the world without food, people without stability, and people who do not have the tools or opportunities to lift themselves out of poverty. With the challenges facing the world today, it is imperative that we remember the legacy of the scientists and teachers who came before us and continue to build on their work to increase the world's food supply, improve the environment, and build on our knowledge of the world around us.